There are a number of tools within Adobe Acrobat Pro 11 that you can use to enhance the accessibility of a PDF. In this video, I'll focus on the two most important tools, the Make Accessible Wizard and the Touch-Up Reading Order tool. Now, these two tools will not solve all your accessibility issues, but they should help you address the most common issues. Please note that while you can create accessible PDF files within Acrobat, the interface itself is not very accessible. You do have to be able to see the screen and use a mouse to use the tools described in this video. When I'm editing the accessibility of a PDF, the first tool I usually open is the Make Accessible Wizard. To access the wizard, select Tools from the upper right part of the screen, and the Tools sidebar should appear. Under the Action Wizard panel, select Make Accessible, and then Start. This will run you through a number of steps. First, you'll add a title to your document. Every PDF should have a descriptive title, so I'm going to deselect the Leave As Is checkbox and give this a succinct title. The rest of the fields can be left alone, so just select OK to move on. Next, Acrobat will try to recognize the text in a scanned PDF. This is not a scanned PDF, but I always hit OK anyway. It will next ask if this is a form. If it is, select Yes, Detect Form Fields. If not, select No, Skip This Step. Next, select the language. In this case, it's English. The next step is Add Tags to Document. PDF tags provide accessibility information to screen readers. This PDF file already has tags, so Acrobat will skip this step, but if your document does not have tags, you'll be prompted to add them. Now Acrobat's going to detect any figures or images within the document. You'll notice this Adobe logo is highlighted, and there's a box where I can enter alternative text. I'm going to give this image alternative text of Adobe. If there are multiple images on the page, I can use the previous and next arrows to go through every image. I just have the one image, so I'm going to select Save and Close. The last step is the accessibility checker. I'll select Start Checking. After the checker is complete, you'll see the accessibility checker panel open on the left-hand side. This will identify issues that need to be checked manually, like contrast, or issues that you still need to address, such as missing table headers. Okay, the wizard is complete, so I'm going to select Close in the upper right corner, and then I'm done. The second tool I want to show you is the Touch-Up Reading Order tool. It can be found in the Accessibility section within the same tool's sidebar. If you don't see accessibility in the sidebar, select the Show or Hide Panels option in the top right corner of the sidebar, and make sure accessibility is selected from the list. Within the accessibility menu, select Touch-Up Reading Order, and the Touch-Up Reading Order tool window will appear. Gray boxes will also appear that outline the tag structure of the page. You'll notice small white squares at the start of each box that currently display the reading order of the page. I usually like to make sure the tag structure of the page is correct first and then fix the reading order, so I'm going to select the Structure Types radio button. These white boxes should now display the PDF tag information. For example, H1 is a heading 1 and P is for paragraph or body text. If you see text that doesn't have a gray box around it, that's because it's not tagged. You can address this by dragging a box around the text, and I've found that you want to make the box a bit bigger than the text you're trying to select. Then select the correct tag from the Touch-Up Reading Order window, in this case Heading 2. Then I want to go through this page and just make sure everything is tagged correctly. The H3 right here should probably be a Heading 2. I want to make sure the table is correct accessibility information, so I'll select the table by clicking on the little white square next to it and selecting Table Editor within the Touch-Up Reading Order tool. Red lines within the table indicate different table cells, and the gray boxes indicate that these are data cells. Some of these cells should be table headers, so to fix this, I'm going to draw a little box over these three top cells. I need to be careful to draw the box inside these red cell lines. Then I'll right-click and select Table Cell Properties. The Table Cell Properties box will appear, and I want to select Header Cell instead of Data Cell. Now I'll give these a scope, in this case column, because these are column headers. You can also select Scope Row to create row headers if necessary. Hit OK, and now you'll notice these three cells now have a red background, indicating that they're headers. Click anywhere else on the page, and the Touch-Up Reading Order tool reappears. Next, you'll notice this footer text. Often, you'll want to hide text like this from a screen reader, especially after the first page of a multi-page PDF. To do this, select the text, and then select Background in the Touch-Up Reading Order window. You can use Background to hide any decorative images or text that you think should be ignored by a screen reader. You can also use the Touch-Up Reading Order tool to check and change your reading order. To do this, select the Page Content Order radio button, and now the little white boxes display numbers, which indicate the reading order of the page. So let's check this reading order. 1, 2, 4, 3. So 3 and 4 are out of order. Now I can fix this by selecting the Show Order Panel option in the tool. Within this panel, I can use my mouse to select this number 4, and then drag it between 2 and 3. So now 1, 2, 3, 4 looks like the reading order is now correct. This video is meant to be used in companionship with the Goals Cheat Sheets, which are non-technical one-page resources. To view these cheat sheets or for more information about the Goals Project, visit ncdae.org.